On today's episode, I'm going to show you a new plugin that's available in Cura 4.4. I'm also going to show you a problem that I found while I was testing with the stock extruder on an Ender 3. I know some people have replaced the PTFE tube or done other things, but still have under extrusion. This could be the problem. I'll show you what it is and that plugin on today's Filament Friday. Filament Friday is brought to you by these Patreon supporters. I've been testing out the new Ultimaker Cura version 4.4, and here it is. I got the CHEP cube loaded, so I'll click on About Cura just to prove this is version 4.4. Frankly, there's not a whole lot new in this. One thing I did like is when I installed it on my Mac, it automatically brought in all my profiles, so that was nice. I didn't have to reload profiles. That seemed to work well. So what I want to do is just slice this CHEP cube at 0.28 layer height. It says it's going to take 29 minutes. Now what I wanted to show you is this modified G-code script. It's a new one. The person who created it actually tipped me off to this. They left a message in one of my videos. And so I'm going to scroll up here to display remaining time in LCD. And I know display is spelled wrong. So does he. He's going to fix it. But what this does is actually display on the LCD how much time is left of the print. So I'll check the box to enable it, and then that'll make the little wrench appear. Still 29 minutes, so it's not going to take any longer to do this. Let's send this to an Ender 3 and see what it looks like. So it's heated up the bed, it's heated up the hot end, and it's actually going to start printing because you can see it's already taken 1 minute, 4% done according to that. But it still says extruder heating. So it's a little bit delayed, but then it says 28 minutes and 8 seconds, even though above it, it says 2 minutes completed. So that implies it's 30 minutes, but I know Cura said 29. But basically, every layer jumps to a new layer, it updates the time left. So there's 27 minutes, now there's 26 minutes. I sped this up a little bit. So it works pretty good. So that's an interesting app, but what's even more interesting is what happened to my printer. I used my printer that I just recently put new Capricorn tubing and couplings on it, and look at the results I got from this thing. Totally under extruded, a terrible, terrible print. And what's ironic is I've been getting a lot of emails and questions from people saying they replaced their Capricorn tubing, put a new nozzle on it, did all kinds of things, and still can't get rid of the under extrusion. Well, let me show you what I found. I reran the print and the first layer just looked awful, just terrible as you can see. So I knew I had an under extrusion problem, so I decided to just change the nozzle. So I unscrewed it and then let it cool and then took a look at it. It seemed fine, but I decided to put a new one in anyway. So I grabbed the new nozzle, tightened it up, and then tried printing it again. And I started to get the same results. But then you could see it started to get better. Well, that's because I pulled on the lever arm and this seemed to push the filament through better. So I knew there was slipping going on here. So I decided to look even closer at it. I let go of the arm and check it out. The idler arm is not riding against the gear. The idler wheel is not spinning. So the filament is just slipping. And this was the problem. I loosened the lever arm screw like I showed in a previous video. That didn't help. It seemed the only thing that worked is if I pulled on the lever. So I put down another first layer and I held the lever the whole time. And it came out really good. So then I stopped the print. That's what the little blob is. So pulling this lever fixes it. But as I pulled on it, I could feel something wasn't right. Something was flexing. I pulled the lever arm off and I didn't notice it at first, but then I saw this hairline crack. And when I pulled the two apart, the crack opened up. This is what was causing the problem. It's flexing and preventing the idler from riding tight against the gear. A while ago, I had bought one of these CHPOWER all aluminum extruder. I never installed it on a machine, so I took it out of the package and I decided to try it on this machine. I've showed you a dual gear drive, I've showed you the EZR, but this is just like a direct replacement for the Creality. And I decided I wanted to just try the arm, see if just the arm would fit and work. So I put the pieces together to form the arm. First the bearing with a screw, and then you slide in the insert, and this is the pivot that the arm, you know, rides again, it's like a bearing. And I put the screw in. And then I had to have one more screw to guide the spring. So I put that in, and then I installed this onto the stock extruder. So I'm using the same plastic base, but I screwed it in with the original spring. And it worked. I mean, everything lined up, the wheel was turning, and I was getting a very good print. As you can see right here, the flow is perfect. So I really don't need to replace the whole thing, but I'm going to do that anyway. I made sure power was off, and then I disconnected the extruder wire from the stepper motor. Then I unscrewed the Capricorn tubing, and I had already taken the filament out. So then I needed to remove the new arm, which I had tested. So I pulled that off, and then there's three screws left to take the top off and away from the stepper motor. Now, I'm going to put the new gear on, but I compared the diameter. They're identical, so I shouldn't have to do anything with E-steps. So I put the new base back on, just basically the same three screws. Then I put the new gear on and adjusted it so it's centered to the filament. Then it came in a little lock washer, so I flattened that and put it underneath the arm to give it a little better pivot, then tightened the arm down against this metal base. Then there was a screw. There's no tightening screw. It just goes into the spring and guides it. Then I put the coupling back on. The last step was to reconnect the wiring to the stepper motor and then reprint it. And when I reprinted it, it came out so much better. Here it is with the new metal extruder. This isn't a perfect print. It's a 0.28, but it's so much better than what I had before. I can't believe that just a hairline crack in that arm caused this much trouble. So there's something to look for. You may have a cracked arm or something similar. So this is an easy replacement, $10, all metal. I got this on Amazon. You can probably get a little cheaper if you go to Banggood. I'll put links to this in the description below. The only thing I wish that could print the super flexible Ninja Flex. And this one can't either, which surprised me. This is the same dual drive that's on the CR10S Pro. I mounted this on an Ender 3 in a previous video. It works really well. It's a little bit more money at $15. You can get it from various places. I'll put links to this. But this one can't do the super, you know, flexible. For that, I go to the EZR. This is the EZR extruder from CME CNC. It's the same one that's on their $2,000 Artemis Delta printer. Works fantastic. Works for any filaments, not just NinjaFlex, but it does NinjaFlex beautifully. I showed this in a previous video. It's a lot more expensive at $35 to $40. I'll put a link to this in the description. This is my favorite extruder for any Creality machine, especially the Ender 3. I'm continuing to play with Cura 4.4 to find out what changed. It's really, really minor. It seems like what's changed, a lot of bug fixes, I guess. It really was to help Ultimaker users with some new profiles. Other than that, it's really, really minor. So I may do a video of this in the future. I may just wait until version 4.5. But in the meantime, check out this time left. See if you like it. I'm not sure I like it enough to take away that last line because a lot of times I display my file name down there. So this may lose out to that, but it's a nice feature. Check it out. Give that plugin a try and let me know what you think. And if you had a cracked extruder arm, let me know in the comments below.